unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning. I have written unto you, young men, because ye are strong, and the word of God abideth in you, and ye have overcome the wicked one. 1 John chapter 2, verse 14.
Your salvation and your prosperity is in your personal relationship with God.
God also has exalted him and given him a name that is above every other name.
No matter who you are, you cannot make it in this life without the word of God.
So shall my word that goes forth from my mouth, it shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the things for which I sent it. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11. This message is from the Apostolic Church, Ghana. Keep watching the Apostolic Heritage on this channel. God bless you.
is as if young one and Iradia Bibiama Yang. We want to do this together. So if you don't mind, kindly be on your feet and let's sing and dance unto the Lord. The Lord has been good and his mercies endureth forever. Are you ready? Hallelujah.
Today's message.
For some past months now, we've been treating a very interesting chapter in the Bible, which is Psalm 23. We've gone through the first five verses.
And
we are dealing with the very last verse. A verse that is very, very exciting. You know, in the first verse, the psalmist lays the foundation of a blessed relationship. He goes by saying the Lord is. Some people have not defined who their God is. But he said the Lord he is. And the Bible says those who come to God must believe that he is.
The Bible says one by name and say one Jesus is
Owoho. What is he? Who is he?
Oyehwanya
Oyedien. He is my shepherd. And then he goes on to say, because he is my shepherd, I will not lack any good thing. I shall not want. Then you see from the second verse to the fifth verse, he goes to explain some of the reasons why he will not want. He gives you some pictorial detail that he will bring me to the greener pastures. He will bring me to the still waters. He will lead me in the paths of righteousness. He will restore my soul. He's giving you some of the details why he's saying, I shall not
want.
Then in the verse 6, which is the last verse, he gives a summary and a conclusion of all that he has said. This is how I look at the psalm. And the first word he brings there is surely. Let me hear you say surely.
Surely.
Let's go again, surely.
Surely.
What does surely mean? Surely means what? Yes. Surely is surely. It's certain. There's no argument. There is no change. It's going to be. It is fixed. It's a rock. It's unmovable. It's unchangeable. It is sure. And
We all know this, that nothing in this life is sure. Even the earth is not sure, because the earth will pass away. The skies unsure, because the skies will pass away. Governments are changing.
Among your four, yes, it's our
riches will pass away. Human beings will die. We used to say that the only sure thing in life is death. Even death, I want to suggest to you, is not sure. Why? It's not everyone who is going to die, some will be raptured. Are you here with me? So even death is not that sure. Nothing is sure in this life. So if you want to be sure of life, then you don't have to put your trust into anything that is not sure. There is only one thing that is sure in life. And what is sure in this life is not the thing, but is a personality. Only God is sure. I said only God is sure. So you can never say surely concerning anything if you are not talking about God. It's not going to happen. You know, we've heard of people who were so rich, they said they will never be poor, but they were found wanting. What do you depend on in this life? Only God is sure, because only God is unchanging. And he says in Malachi 3:6, for I am the Lord, I do not change. Therefore you are not consumed, O sons of Jacob. So the surely the psalmist used there was because he was talking about God. No investment is sure. No bank is sure. No government is sure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But because he was talking about God, and if you look at the psalm clearly, you will see it. Repeatedly, he's talking about He, you, your. I mean, he makes me lie now in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores, he leads. Then he comes to your rod, your staff. You are with me. You prepare, you anoint. Everything is about him.
Now,
so he can say surely. For most of us, there are other things in our lives. Our lives are filled with other things, and then we try to spice it with God. But God is the main cause. God is the main cause. You can only say surely if God fills it all. For your life to be sure, he must be your beginning. He must be your continuation. He must be your end. For he is the author and the finisher of our faith. Let me ask you, what do you depend on in this life? Your riches, your beauty. When I see some young ladies deceiving themselves these days, I get amazed. It's true, they are beautiful. But they never forget that this beauty will not last. Oh, men will be calling you, men will be chasing you, people will be showering gifts upon you. You'll be turning your neck like a queen. I want to assure you, the next generation to overthrow your beauty, you are seeing them.
You are seeing them.
They are a sure sign that your time will soon be over. Those same men who are adoring you, the next time they hear you are coming, they send a message that you should be told they are not there. Why? Another beauty has popped up. You are expiring. They are coming. Are you here with me? Some depend on their name. The family names. And strangely, some women even marry because of family names. Especially if you go into certain tribes and certain kingdoms. When they mention the name, yes, wako ebusuem. Nadin wenzu de if you hear. What do you pride in? What do you depend upon? Some depend on their strength. Some depend on their connections. Some even depend on their parents forever. I know some adults who've been married for years. Yet whenever he's faced with a situation, he must call his father. Grow up. What did I say? Grow up. There's nothing wrong going to your father for advice once a while. But if you are a man, be a man. Because before you get married, the Bible says you leave your father and mother. Have a mind of your own. I'm talking to someone, I said, have a mind of your own. All else will fail. Only God cannot fail. You see, these things that people depend on, they look okay and they look strong. They look like they are going to hold until trouble comes. It is when trouble comes, then you realize that, oh, the things you were depending on for help, those things themselves need help.
I just say, or how about and so bon say, no more do want to say, Bob, no, Sanya, and Casa Crow won't hear more.
And until they get their help, they can't help you.
Now, because this is a won't be and one won't end me more.
So, why should I depend on you when I can depend on the person who does not need help?
And the adding, Sam, me, me, Hoberto, so, oh, so, not in a mem for me, want to near or no, oh, yeah, or be a more.
And can always be my help.
Now, be a bit to me, Abuani.
It makes me like the words of this song that says, will your anchor hold? You see, it is in the times of trouble that you will be tested, and then the cords of your life, okay, will be pulled apart, and that is when we'll realize whether your foundation will hold or not.
Or how ba nese wa bra bonu yet no etiche honey ebehu se.
So he says, will your anchor hold in the storms of life? When the clouds unfold their wings of strife, when the strong tides lift and the cables strain, will your anchor drift or it will firm remain? Then he goes on to say, we. Oh, I just believe I'm talking about you too. He said, we have an anchor. We have an anchor that keeps the soul. It keeps the soul steadfast. It keeps the soul sure even while the billows roll. Steadfast to that rock. That rock, Jesus. The unmovable Savior. That rock which cannot move. We are grounded firm and deep in that Savior's love. Nothing can separate us from the rock of our lives. Oh, some songs are inspiring. Another one says, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock, the unfailing rock, I stand. Because I know that all other ground, no matter how they appear, is just sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. If you're standing on any ground that is not Jesus,
so
no matter how solid it feels, I want you to know it is sinking sand. And the time shall come, you begin to sink. And if you are listening to me and in your life you are sinking now, you can do what Peter did. You can call upon the rock of life. You can call upon Jesus now. Stretch forth your hand and say, save me. And he will save you. He is the only rock that can save. His goodness and his mercy.
You
see, mercy means you are guilty. Mercy means there's a punishment for you. But mercy means I am absorbing you off that penalty. And God can justly do that. Because he's already nailed our sins to the cross. I said he has nailed our sins to the cross. So his goodness and his mercies shall follow us. Child of God, don't let the battles in your life frustrate you. No matter how many times you fall, rise and keep walking. I said rise and keep walking. Rise and keep walking. The only one who is a failure is the one who stays down. But you see, when we are born into God, we are not born as adults. No matter how old you are, you are born as a child. And when a child is born, that child must learn to sit. That child must learn to crawl. And that child must learn to walk. I've never seen any child get up one day and just begin to walk. When they get up, sometimes they fall. And sometimes they get hurt. But they never give up. Why? They see adults walking. So they know it is possible. I'm telling you, it is possible. It is possible for you to live a victorious life in this land of the living. It is possible for you to live above sin. Because Jesus did it for us. And he is your coach when you are walking. I said he is your coach when you are walking. He is leading you. He is helping you. He is holding you. He is guiding you. No matter how many times you fall, know that it is possible. Get up and walk.
Sorry, nanante.
Get up and walk.
Sorry, nanante.
Don't sleep in that sin.
And that was our bonding.
Don't remain in that disgrace.
And tinasa nimguase nimu.
Get up.
Sorry.
For mercy.
If he said, Ehumobo,
mercy has located you.
Ehumobo, enyang.
His goodness and his mercy shall follow us. How many days?
All the days.
How many days?
All the days.
Oh, Jesus.
Na yem yeni ne humobo no ebedi enti yem kwande ina.
What a word. All the days.
All the days.
I don't know how long my days are.
Me nim bredo dua minda ebedi.
But this I know.
But nansu wey dey mean
that all of those days.
Say sa ndanina.
I said all of those days.
Say sa ndanina.
His goodness.
Na yem ye.
And his mercy.
Eni ne humobo no.
Shall follow who? Shall follow who?
Me.
How many days? All the days. So listen to this, child of God. The blessing of God upon your life does not depend on where you are. It does not depend on your physical location. Sometimes some people think that, oh, you are being blessed because you are in this position, and they push you out of that position. Whether they push you from there or not, you are blessed.
I mean,
Joseph's brothers, they thought that Joseph's blessing only depended on his father. So they pushed him away. They placed him in the pit. He was blessed. They sold him into slavery. He was blessed. He was serving in Potiphar's house. He was blessed. He went into prison. He was blessed. He became a prime minister. He was blessed. Listen to me, church. Even when he was dead, he was blessed. The only man whose bones reached the promised land. Even when I die, I am blessed. For the blessing of God upon my life shall flow through generations after me. How many days of your life?
What all the days?
How many days of your life?
All the days.
The only thing that can separate you from your blessing is anything that is able to separate you from your shepherd. For the foundation of your blessing,
if you say,
depends on the relationship with your shepherd. So stay connected to Jesus. And his goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Let me end with this song. He says, in Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. No power of hell, no scheme of man could ever pluck me from his hands. Till he returns, Lord, or calls me home, here, in the power of Christ, I stand.
Hallelujah.
I choose to stand in the power of Christ and not in my own power. Man can choose to scheme. Hell can choose to boil. So long as my shepherd lives, I shall live also. For his goodness and mercy are yours. God bless you.
Amen.
shall we arise. Shall we arise.
Today's message.
It is a joy to welcome you once again to the Apostolic Heritage. I believe that Psalm 23 has been a blessing to you because it's been a very great blessing to me. It's a chapter I can feast in all my life and still be full. Because you find God in every verse of it. And wherever you find God, you find all you need.
Now,
therefore, thank God for this last part of it. We've dealt with all the verses, and we are in verse number 6, which says, surely. Let me hear you say it for me, surely.
Surely.
I love that word.
Surely.
Look, many things in life are so uncertain.
But
surely. If I can't be sure of anything, I can be sure of this one. Surely. Goodness and mercy shall follow me. I don't know about you, but it shall follow me. We're talking about his goodness and his mercy. And we are saying that it shall follow us. Not some days of our lives, but all of it. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
All of the days of our lives. And we fail to understand what follows. So we look into our lives and we don't find goodness and mercy. We confess it. We pray it, but we don't find it because we have failed to satisfy the condition that brings it. We have failed to take hold of the condition that makes it happen. And that condition is what we are talking about. And I will dwell. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. This is a choice that we all have to make. A choice of dwelling in a certain place. For that is where the blessing is. What place are we talking about? The description we have here is the house of the Lord. So we ask ourselves, where is the house of the Lord? Is it Jerusalem? Then we must all travel. So the poor can't make it. The poor will not have goodness and mercy. Is it upon Mount Zion?
Then
apart from traveling, you must climb. Old ladies, old men cannot enjoy goodness and mercy because their knees can't climb. Is it in Solomon's temple? Is it in this house? Where is it? Where is the house of the Lord? We must find this place, because until you find this place, goodness and mercy will just be something you hear about or you talk about or you pray about, but you won't enjoy it.
Because
goodness and mercy can only be found in that place that we call the house of the Lord.
If it's a year now, do you need me home over? You've been home, baby, I'm afraid of you.
So let's ask ourselves, where does God live? If you find where he lives, then you have found his house. Where does he live? This big God, into what house or what space can you confine him? So where does God live? Isn't he omnipresent? Isn't this God omnipresent?
So
if he is omnipresent, then why are we limiting him to a particular place or space?
And so you'll be a wo baby a prekopa. I didn't think a ye pese ye didn't tina baby far could be.
The house of God.
Nyami fie.
Where will we find it?
Ehi ena ye be hun ni fie wo.
One time Jacob was on a journey.
Bivina Jacob e tu kwan.
He was running away from his brother.
No, o jani efine brother.
Because his life was in danger.
If he said na onya na obeku.
He had done something he shouldn't have done.
Oye bibia na answer say oye.
Going through the bush at that time.
Onna me sorry no musa bre no.
It became dark.
Ena esum to no.
So he had to sleep.
Ntina say order.
Oh. Such a rich man's son.
Odifo kese weba.
He had to sleep.
Ese say order.
In the bush. He looked for a pillow.
No, she says Sunday.
He found none. What he used for a pillow was a stone. But that night.
Nanso sana juno.
I said, but that night.
He says, sir, anajuno.
You know, sometimes when you are in the worst seasons of your life,
that
is when you get the best revelations of your life. Sometimes when people think they have pushed you out of your destiny, that is rather when you begin to discover your destiny. Sometimes when you think you have lost all your riches, that is when you begin to discover the true riches of life. That night, he saw something he had never seen before. He saw a wonderful dream. In that dream, there was a ladder from earth to heaven. And the angels were going up and down.
And I saw above for F what train you
and he saw the Lord on top there.
And who ready our trainers row.
And God spoke to him in that dream.
And then Yamene no Kasai was had I soon.
And when he woke up,
oh sorry, you know.
Wow.
See,
he was frightened.
Who a can
he was shocked.
A year no one.
He said, this is an awesome place.
I say I had a higher one.
This is the house of God.
Aha, a Yami fee.
If that is the house of God,
then
we all still have to do what? Travel. But no. That is not the house of God. He called it the house of God. And by that he gave us the definition. The house of God is the place where God manifests himself. So God is omnipresent. It means God is everywhere. But we all know that God does not manifest himself everywhere. So where God's manifest presence is, that is where we are calling the house of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
God has also said that he will manifest himself in certain situations. He says his eyes are moving to and fro throughout the whole earth that he might show himself strong. I will show my power. I will manifest myself. And he said, on behalf of those whose hearts are loyal to him. So all you need to do to make yourself or your heart his house is to let him in. If you are an unbeliever, if you haven't been born again, what it means is that you come to the realization that you are a sinner. And that you need a savior. And that the judgment of God is upon you. But Jesus, through love, has died to pay the price for your sins.
Yes, Christ,
if you can accept what he's done for you, if you will agree that the shedding of his blood is adequate compensation for your sins, and if you will ask him that, Lord, come in. I am thine. I give myself to you. Take me and save
me.
He will save you. Are you here with me? So that is step number one. Step number two. When he comes in, you must honor his presence. You can look at Joseph's life. God honored Joseph because Joseph honored God's omnipresence. Hello. How do we know this? Though he was sold into slavery, though they did many things against him, the Bible said, and the Lord was with Joseph. Hello.
Hi.
And the Lord was with what? Joseph.
Nana Eradika Joseph.
And because the Lord was with him, goodness and mercy followed him. He prospered. How did he honor God's omnipresence? You know the story. One day, his master's wife wanted to do something evil with this young guy. He wanted to have sexual contact with him. This guy said, no. And his no was no. In this current world, sorry if you're a female, sorry for that. But averagely, when a woman says no, it means maybe. If you continue asking, you see that the no begins to change. Because she says no.
If you saw, I see Debbie,
but she will take your gifts.
Now, so I bet you watch it.
She says no.
I see Debbie.
She will go out with you.
I know Uber Pierre.
She says no.
I see Debbie.
But she will sit in your car.
I bet
in our
car.
She says no.
I see Debbie.
She will come to your hall.
I bet Baba Uber.
She says no.
I see Debbie.
She will eat the fried rice.
I bet the fried rice. I bet your man no.
Yet she's saying no.
Ni neti no. I see Debbie.
When Joseph said no. The Bible said, he refused to be with her.
Betina
minchempo wa ma. Now the old betina ho. Oso umozi ojaisa. Mimpesa. Nso ti ho. Are you here with me? It doesn't make sense. When this woman said, come, look at the security or guarantee she gave Joseph. She said, Joseph, There's no one in the house.
Joseph,
we are alone. Do you understand that? There's no one here. We are alone. I know you like it, but you are afraid you'll be caught. So today, I've made a special arrangement. There is no one here. Come.
Bra.
Come.
Bra.
This guy said no.
A brand take I said, Debbie.
If persuasion fails, force must be applied. The woman grabbed. No. What he was wearing as a chief servant. It was his glory. It was his position. The woman took hold of it. And Joseph let her have it.
And Joseph ma no fast atari no.
Obi anko beka se debi. Minu anum jim atari edi kain. I'm your papa, dear mommy. Way dear, no way. Minu be pray, 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 minu be pray. Now wa huo dingi na. Eba hunam akonomu asema. When it comes to issues about lust, the Bible did not say be strong. The Bible said flee.
Eba hunam akonu ansema. Bible ankase ma ohunye de. Bible si jane.
Wankase manunsu so munakase jai jai jai. Na wo yemre ba obedu baby na o voice jai no kura dani sexy. Wo encourage no. Enye se wo jai wo encourage no. Some people, it's rather when they are close to their blessing that the devil opens a door of escape from their blessing and they walk out.
Ebinum bra won wa ben won sira no sa bre no e no tamfo no e bie opun bi ma o na won twane e fi won sira no ko.
Si ma bre ma kan ya che no tie ne ni pe ka. Na si chere. Men so me fabi baby. No ko. Na wa shrini nchira. Listen. For you to enjoy his goodness and mercy all the days of your life, you need to stay.
Sene beya ni yiye ye ene na doye mobo hunu ubenye hon faso unkwande inano en humbe yasa obetina.
Some will leave.
Ebinu mbeko.
Upper left.
Upper ekoye.
But Ruth stay.
Nancy Ruth there or tonight.
Are you here with me? The 9 lepers who were healed, they left. But the one who was a Samaritan stayed. It got to a time a lot of the disciples left Jesus. It was the 12 and some few who remained. Because he said certain things they did not understand. Then he asked his disciples, will you also go? And Peter said, where will we go?
Petro can say, na ehi na yebeko.
You have the words of eternal life. We have no place. Because we have no God.
If you say
other than you.
Say you
we are here to stay.
Say
we are here to stay.
Say
Jesus puts it in another way. He uses the word abide.
Yes, so
if you go to John 15, he's trying to say that if you abide in me and my words abide in you, if you stay in me, not if you visit me, if you stay.
And yes, I will be best.
Then you will ask whatever you will, and it shall be done unto you.
And need a bisa be open na ye de.
What a promise. But it belongs to those who stay. It belongs to those who dwell. where his presence is.
He
belongs to those who honor him. He's saying dwell means you can go.
So
it is a choice. You read Exodus 21. Let me try and end with this story. He talks about the situation when you have an Hebrew slave. If you have a slave that is a Hebrew, that person can serve you only for 6 years.
So
in the seventh year, you must let him go free.
He's
going, he can go with his wife and children if he brought them.
So
but if you give him a wife, then he has to leave the wife and the children for you. Go.
You are
free. But there was a clause. If that servant says, my master, I love you, I don't want to go. I like the life I have with you. I don't only like your wages. I like your relationship more than the wages. The problem in Christianity today, that a lot of people come in just because of breakthrough and blessing and not the relationship. But the clause is, if the servant says, master, no, I don't want to leave you. I still want to continue and serve you as a slave. Then he says the master can take him to the door and pierce his ear with an awl to the door. And then he will become his bond servant forever. He could go out, but he could also choose to stay. I choose to stay. I choose to go for the relationship. I choose to serve this master. I choose to serve this God. In your honoring him, you can go hungry sometimes. You will be rejected sometimes. But that is only for a season. I said it is only for a season. It is a trial of your faith. But that day will come when he will anoint your head with oil. When he will set a table before you in the presence of your enemies. I love those words. Hey, nipa kura na otimi to he will set a table before me, even in the presence of my enemies. One day, the enemies who are looking for your life to kill you, they will stand and see you before your banquet. And those are the very people who will begin to hail you for what God has done in your life. When Joseph was riding in the chariot through Egypt, and they were saying, all should bow. That all should bow included Potiphar's wife.
Na Potiphar yere eka ho.
Included Potiphar himself.
Na Potiphar nkasa eka ho.
Your day will come.
Woda ebeba.
Your day will come.
Woda ebeba.
Because you serve a living God.
If you say,
may his goodness and mercy follow you all the days of your life. And may you be careful to dwell in his house forever and ever. God bless you.